मोहम्मद हमदुल्ला सईद, हमदुल्ला सईद नहीं इसके लड़के हैं।
प्रेसिडेंट फॉर एड्रेसिंग द सेंट्रल हॉल द बोथ द हाउसेस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट एंड एज वी ऑल नो this custom has been borrowed from the Westminster system. This custom has been followed ever since independence, and the honorable president had expressed her views on the policies of the government, which the government of the day plans to take, and the policies that have already been implemented by the government. The honorable president is the head of the state and is also the head of the executive. In the Indian parliamentary democracy, the parliament is incomplete without the president. Sir, if we carefully look at and analyze the speech of the honorable president, we can make out that the UPA government is committed to solve the issues of health, education, employment, inflation, corruption, and food security, public distribution system, and also climate change. Various issues have been covered in the president's honorable president's speech. I would first of all take up the issue of inflation. If we look at inflation, what is inflation? Basically, inflation can be defined as general rise in prices measured against standard level of purchasing power of the customers. I do agree with my opposition members and friends who are sitting in the opposition benches that the prices of rice, wheat, sugar, vegetables, fruits and edible oils and other essential commodities have increased. But when you compare the prices of essential commodities that were prevalent at the time of NDA regime, the present prices of essential commodities are far better. And I would also like to inform you, sir, and this august house that I have not forgotten when BJP government was there in Delhi. And BJP was ousted out of Delhi only on account of exorbitant onion prices. And I also would like to remind the honorable members on the opposition benches that during the BJP regime in Delhi, one of the famous BJP leaders said, "Agar pyaaz ke daam agar mehenge hain, to kya hua? Pyaaz khane ki zarurat nahi hai." Lekin humne kabhi ye nahi kaha ki pyaaz mat khaiye ya aap aloo mat khaiye ya tomato mat khaiye. We never said that. And also, sir. The UPA government is committed to bring the proposed national food security law, which will ensure that essential commodities are given to all the below poverty line families at highly subsidized prices. But the National Advisory Council chairperson Shrimati Sonia Gandhi has categorically reiterated that the public distribution system should be universalized, and it should not only cover the below poverty line families, but it should also cover APL families. That will cover a huge chunk of middle class families also. And by universalizing the PDS, the BPL and the APL families will be in a position to get highly subsidized essential commodities even during the time of inflation. And I would ask. And I would request the opposition members also to support this national food security law, because if this law is enacted, if this is materialized, this is not only going to help the BPL families. If the recommendation of the NSE is accepted and if it is materialized, it will also help the APL families. In one way, this will contain inflation, and in another way, this is also going to universalize the public distribution system, because there have been a lot of loopholes and bottlenecks in the public distribution system. Sir, the government of India has also taken measures to contain inflation. The rules and regulations for import of essential commodities have been liberalized. Import has been liberalized, and export of essential commodities like pulses and cereals is already banned. Therefore, these are some of the few steps which the government has taken, and which was also mentioned in the speech of the honorable president. The second issue that I would like to take up is with regard to corruption. The probity in public life is very essential. It is important. The honorable president had also expressed her views that corruption we need to tackle. The government is committed. It has already constituted a group of ministers which will take legislative decisions and which will also take administrative actions to ensure that corruption is not there in public life. Resignation of the Maharashtra Chief Minister and also resignation of Mr. Kalmadi from the Congress Parliamentary Party as the secretary's post is an example that even before based on mere allegations, they have resigned. They have not yet been convicted. The investigation is going on. Interrogation is still going on. Based on the investigation only, they have resigned. And based on mere allegations, they have not yet been convicted. If you look at the NDA regime, I would like to remind my friends in the opposition benches that during the NDA regime, the then defense minister was involved in the coffin scam. He resigned, and even before the investigation got completed, he again took back charge as the defense minister itself, that too in the same portfolio. I also would like to remind my honorable BJP members and the opposition members that during the BJP regime, when the NDA government was in power, at that point of time, the BJP president was caught in camera receiving bribe of just 1 lakh rupees. So I would say that once you point out finger towards the Congress party or the government, the rest 4 fingers are pointing towards you. Yesterday, I was listening to the Honorable Rajnath Singh Ji, the former BJP president. He was saying that Congress is drowned in corruption. Congress ke andar, Congress, matlab, aisa kuwa hai jisme sirf bhang, jo, matlab, jo usme piye paani, wo usme bhangi bhange. To main ye kehna chahunga कि आप अपने आप को देखें. आपका जो वर्किंग प्रेसिडेंट थे उनको खुद 1 लाख रुपए कैमरा में पकड़ा गया और बंगारू लक्ष्मण जी आपको याद होगा तो. और उसके बाद मैं the other issue that I would like to take up is with regard to judiciary. Judiciary, the government is committed to improve the image of judiciary and the presiding officers and the judicial
please
officers.
Conclude now, conclude.
Sir, give me 2 minutes, sir. I've been waiting for last 2 days, sir.
Okay, okay. 2 minutes given.
Sir, youngest member, sir, youth is having a lot of hope with the parliament and with the country, sir. So what I would like to say, sir, in the judiciary is the third organ of the government. Judiciary's basic job, which has been envisaged in the constitution, is interpretation of law. And if you look at judiciary, there have been cases of the judges and judicial officers being corrupt. The government is already committed to even improve the efficiency and image of judiciary and to ensure that there is expeditious disposal of cases, there is no pendency of cases, and for that the judges accountability bill has already been introduced in this in the Lok Sabha, in the parliament, and very soon with the materialization of this law, of course with the support of the opposition, principal opposition party, if they don't disrupt the house, I'm sure that this will get materialized and the judiciary will also improve upon its image. So therefore, sir, there are so many issues. The next issue that I would like to take up is the law and order, the internal security, which the President of India had already expressed in her view, that the law and order is, if you look at the overall condition of the country, the law and order is far better now. And the NIA has been constituted, and terrorist, previously if there was a terrorist attack or if there was terrorism, there was no specific law which could deal with terrorist or which could deal with the trial of terrorists. With the constitution of NIA, National Investigation Agency, there is a law which now clearly defines how, if terrorists are attacked, if terrorists are caught by the investigating authorities, under what laws they are to be tried. NIA is clearly, it has clearly mentioned the this thing. Also, sir, NSD hubs have been established in various cities, in cosmopolitan cities. Multi-agency centers and subsidiary centers have also been, established. With regard to the foreign policy, if you look at the foreign policy,
thank you.
Our government has been committed. It has developed relations with Central Asia, with West Asia, with East Asia, and with other Gulf countries. If you look at the India's membership in the United Nations Security Council as a non-permanent member, that itself is enough to prove that the government of India, the government is committed with regard to the foreign
thank
policy
you, thank
and
you, Sahib.
The countries, the heads of state of the America, Britain, France, China and Russia, they have already supported that
Shri
India will be given a permanent membership in the Security Council. They have already supported. So, sir, this shows that the government of India is also committed on the foreign policy. And, sir, last point, sir, I'll just take 1 minute. And when it comes to climate change, the government has already constituted under a law, there is already a constitution of National Green Tribunal. Now, the National Green Tribunal has been constituted under a specific law by the Environmental Department just to ensure that cases of environment are expeditiously disposed. The government is very committed that there has to be development and infrastructure, but not at the cost of environment and ecology. Projects which are for the development and infrastructure should be only...
Please, Ramesh ji, conclude.
Thank you, sir. With these words, I would support the motion of thanks and would support my proposer and seconder. Thank you.
Ramesh ji.